Hey folks, it's Frithgar here. How you doing? I have finished doing this field, and we're not going to be... I know that we got this one through the hedge here, and, you know, it's kind of pushing what would be acceptable. I don't think we can really, realistically expect to get this down through the farm. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to take this one back up the road. We're going to have to push through the hedge right here, as though we had trimmed the top of the hedge, and come out round onto the road, because we can fit it up the road, okay? And then we're going to go in and we're going to get a header trailer. Before I do that, my question for this week, or what's left of this week, because we had other issues at the beginning of the week, remember? I have this here, the big baler 1290. Do you want me to use that baler to bale up the straw? Or do you want me to use... baling technology. Do you want me to use the small welger baler with the trailer that auto picks up all the small bales? Do you want me to use that one to bale up the wheat straw that we have just combined? It's your vote, it's your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know what you want. And remember, I also said that because things have gotten rather unrealistic with this map, we've broken the immersion completely with major game bugs and issues with the mods. So I've basically said that for the last week or so with this map, I will just kind of have an open house. I will get big mods, I will experiment with a few things, we'll use the money cheat to get whatever it is that we want to get to make it as interesting, humorous, whatever you like, as we possibly can, just for the last week before the new game is launched. So give me suggestions of things that you would like to see. Now I'm trying to decide which... I don't want one of the John Deere ones. I'm thinking maybe that one. We'll go for the 32. And we are going to have... I very often go for purple, because you don't see much purple machinery. Let's go for that one, actually. That's a rather bright color. I think it's just the wheels, actually, that come out of that color. Oh no, it's the bits on the top. Right, so we need to go around to the other side of that trailer. And how am I going to do that? I'm going to have to go across the hedge, aren't I? Going to have to just catch the hedge a little bit. Just sweep... Oh, just made it, actually. So, yeah, give me some suggestions of things that you would like to see me try out on this map. It's kind of a one-off. Any mods that might not normally be realistic that I would probably normally say, no, we're not going to do that. Not next week, but the week after. The final week is going to be kind of the week that I try some of them out. As we've already destroyed immersion on this map, I thought that it might be interesting just to try out a few that we haven't tried before. And I'm thinking that quite big mods would be quite entertaining, especially on this map. But we'll see. We'll see what people suggest. I've had a couple suggestions come in already, and some of them are quite interesting. And so I'm interested to see what else... Oh, no. Right, well, that's... No, I want to lift it back up again. That is definitely far, far away from the realms of realistic. So I need to come down here and... Oh, come a bit closer. There. Take that one off. And now I'm hoping I can lower it slightly and unhitch... No, don't! Ooh, I thought that was going to roll straight off the other side. I have had that happen many, many times. So, yeah, that was lucky. Anyway... We are now going to drag this one down to the farm down there so we can start harvesting the oilseed rape, or canola, in that field right there. We've got to go down to the farm, because that's the only way that we can access that field. I'm hoping that I can actually hitch this trailer on, like this. Back up. Is it going to let me do it? You need to kind of get it lined up. But for some reason, sometimes you can't do it unless you're exactly straight on. So I'm hoping... That is about right. Ooh, right up in the combine there. It's not... Well, at the moment, it's not happy with it. Oh, hang on. It'll let me do it right there. That was actually pretty good. That I don't think that trailer moved at all when I hitched it on then. That was a very fortunate guess. Right. Now, hopefully, the header will stay on the header trailer. And it does have rear wheel steering on the trailer, so... I'm hoping that we'll be able to get through the gateways. I'm going to stay out, and I'm going to watch this one like this. Rather than doing it from in the cab, I want to watch this one get round all of the sharp corners and through the gateways. And round we go. Right, so the first gateway seems fine. Yep. It's down on the farm that I'm more interested in. So I will get down to the farm in a second, and then we can see what it's like getting around all the corners. Right. In round the first corner. This shouldn't be too much trouble. It's a little bit further down, and I'm also hoping that we don't shake that header off of the trailer. Come in here, and that is the corner that I am not sure about. Do we need to approach that from the opposite direction? Do I need to go and turn round so I can get up there? Because that is the only way to get into that field. There's no gateway up there. So the only way into that field is through that gateway there. Are we going to be able to do this? I'll go dead center and start the turn here. It's going to have to turn quite sharp. And now, is that rear wheel steering going to be enough? Is that going to catch the gateway? Oh, that is magical. I am really impressed with that. Did you see that? That actually made it round the corner. It didn't touch the front. That was just fantastic. And again. Oh, I love these trailers. I knew that they had the rear wheel assistance and it helped. I didn't realize it was quite that good. That is quite impressive, I got to be honest. Now, I'm going to pull this one into this field in here, and then we will drive back through so that we can start the harvest. We'll go and get the trailer in a little while, the Flegal Bull on the Sammy up there. Just pull in round here now. If I unhitch, is the trailer going to run away down the hill, or is it going to stay right here? Oh, it's going to stay there. Excellent. That's one thing that I have noticed. You don't have trailers run away down the hill. I'm sure I have seen them move somewhere. I don't know which ones it is. Maybe it was in FS13 instead of this one, but I'm sure I remember a header trailer running away off down the hill, and I got quite concerned because I had to go chasing after it. I really don't remember where it was. Unless it was a mod or something like that. I genuinely don't remember. I'd like to remember because it was quite a unique experience, and it's the sort of thing that I'd want to see again now. So, well, it is going to let me back up. It's sticking a little bit then. Round we go. So we're going to start on this field here, and I've had some suggestions come in for some extra large combines to be used, and I might use an extra large combine, although to be honest, I have used extra large combines elsewhere in other places, so it's not something I'm, you know, really excited about, especially as we're doing a bit of combine. Ooh, no, I don't want to fold it back up again. I want to do that. Oh, attach PTO. I keep forgetting to do that. Come down in here, attach the PTO, get back in, start the combine up. There we go. And now, I'm pretty sure this is the steepest bit, just here. And we don't have any choice. We can't leave a swath with oilseed rape. So we are just going to have to combine like this. It would be pretty cool if you could leave a swath with the oilseed rape or the peas. Oh, we don't actually do peas, do we? I used to bale pea straw. You didn't get very much, but it was very, very nutritious stuff. Just in case anybody was wondering. Also, and I really apologize because I wrote your name down, but I can't find it anywhere. And I was kind of looking while I was recording here for your name. Someone contacted me in the comment section, and was they're from Iceland. Now, Iceland is not a very big country. There's only about 325,000 people that live in Iceland, so there's not a huge number of them. And one of them watches my videos, and that is really, really awesome. And I'm so sorry that I don't remember your name. I did write it down. I will mention it in a future episode. But he was telling me that they don't do very much silage at all in Iceland. And they, in fact, do mostly hay. They've got a load of sheep. Their neighbours have got some cattle. They do a little bit of silage, but most people do hay in Iceland. I don't know why it is that they don't do very much silage. I wouldn't even like to hazard a guess. But they don't do very much silage, and it is mostly hay there. I'm guessing that the machinery needed for doing silage is quite expensive. And considering that Iceland is a small country, it could maybe the cost of the machinery is more well, it's probably going to be more than it is in a lot of other places in the world, and that might be a factor to it. I have got no idea, to be honest. I know that they do have quite long winters in Iceland, so they do need quite a bit of fodder for the stored for the winter compared to other places in the world. I suppose, like northern Canada, you would experience similar kinds of winters. And also in Norway, Sweden, especially in the northern parts of those countries, in Finland and Russia as well, you've got a lot of very, very bitter, long winters. So do places that have longer winters store less silage in favour of having hay? Something else that maybe, right, it doesn't like going backwards. I'm trying to use my pedal to go backwards here, and it doesn't like it. It would probably help if I lifted up the header a bit. Is that because I can go forward? But obviously with the pedals, I've got them set, they're not quite maximum revs. So this doesn't like backing up. It won't even do it. I'm using the keys at the moment to do it, because that will give you, that automatically goes to absolute maximum revs. And it's really painfully slow. And it doesn't like turning the corner either. So let's try turning like that. There we go. And remember, this one is a bit bouncy, isn't it? So that might be affecting it as well. That should be sufficient. So yeah, people who have much colder, longer winters than a lot of us, if any of you are watching, could you please let me know what you use for winter feed? Do you tend to use more hay than the rest of us? Because I know a lot of us, silage is much more popular now than it ever used to be. I mean, many, many years ago, it used to be all hay, but silage is slowly come into it, and most people, the majority of their winter feed is silage. But I mean, if it's bitterly, bitterly cold, do you have problems with the silage not fermenting properly? Do the bacteria not, are they not as effective in a colder climate? Is it that perhaps because it gets so cold in the winter, does that actually affect how the silage can be served? Because obviously silage has still got a lot of moisture in it. And if you absolutely bitterly cold somewhere that you've actually got permafrost, isn't that going to turn a clump of silage or a bale of silage just into one great big icy block that the animals can't actually eat? I really, really don't know. So if anyone from a particularly cold climate has any answers to these questions, I would love for you to get in touch. Head into the comments section, let me know, send me a private message, however you like to do it. I would love to find out if you feed less silage than normal, and if you do, why do you feed less silage than normal? Because I'd love to know the reason for it. That's, I always like to know why. Why is a key factor in so many things in life, and it is in... Right, I'm going to just change that to that one. Why is probably the most important answer that anyone can give. Why do these things happen? Right, while that one starts going around the field on auto combine, I'm going to take a little walk over there, and I'm going to get that Flegel Bull trailer. I'm going to tip the wheat straight into the sell point, and then we're going to bring it back over here so that we can unload our first load of canola. While he is motoring around the field, we will go up here and we will sell our final 3.2 tons of wheat. Not sure what we're going to get for this. I'm hoping that we get a reasonable amount. And I know that I've kind of had a few issues with this map, although I'm starting to think that it might have actually been the beekeeping mod, either because I had two beehive makers and two beekeepers, it might have been that the mod wasn't intended to be used like that, or it was because the placeable mod was conflicting with this map. Other than those couple of little issues, this map is actually really good. I know it's a very small map and not everybody likes the small maps, but this is a kind of one that you can play on a much more casual basis. Big maps tend to take a lot more dedication. If you're going to do something, it takes quite a number of hours to complete any task if you've got more than just a couple of the fields. Whereas this map, it's just a lot quicker. You've got small fields, and you don't have very many of them. So it's a more for a casual gamer. You get to experience the whole spectrum of farming. You get to feel like you're accomplishing something. And you don't have to do it. You don't have to spend many, many, many hours doing it. Because I know that not everybody can do that. I've always been frustrated at times when I can't spend hours gaming. And I felt that it's really held me back and has spoiled my gaming experience. Which is why I like to sort of feature both sides of things. I like to do some stuff with bigger maps, especially my time-lapse. Time-lapse does look very good with a bigger map. But I also like to feature smaller maps. So I'm going to try and do the same in FS17. I'm going to try to feature... my time-lapse will be on a big map. That just goes without saying. But for the rest of it, I would like to try and have one map that is medium to large, and so I can sort of go through different things and have large machinery featured on that one. And then I'll have one map that is medium down to small, and I'll go for slightly smaller machinery on that map, and things will be done slightly differently. So that is kind of how I'm going to continue doing it, because I've had old times on here, and now we've got this one here as well, both small maps. So I will be on the lookout once FS17 comes out for maps of all sizes. So Thursday, Friday and Saturday will continue to be the smaller map, and Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday will continue to be the when I feature the larger map. And then of course I'll have the time lapses on Sunday. I will be moving, I've had a few people asking me to clarify what's going to happen. I will be moving everything to FS17. Unfortunately, I won't be able to continue the old times time lapse. I've had, not the old times, the hard working time lapse. I've had a few people asking me if I could do that. Unfortunately, that isn't going to be possible. I'm not going to be able to do any of the hard working time lapse. I will, just before FS17 is released, so in a couple of weeks' time, I will do the final episode. I will sell all modded machinery on that map, but I will leave all non-modded machinery, and then I will zip up the save game file and I will upload it to FSUK the same as I did with the Bjornholm upload. Although I did have a few people on the Bjornholm one saying that they wish that there was some machinery left, so I will leave any non-modded items in the map just to make it a little bit easier for you. Right, he's not going to back up this hill, is he? It's just not going to happen. So yeah, I will leave non-modded machinery on the map, and remove all modded machinery and items. I will leave a link, obviously, on FSUK to the actual map download, and it'll be up to you whether you want to install the Beef and Pigs mod and any of the other bits and pieces like that. That'll be entirely your decision. But hopefully then you'll be able to sort of carry on, especially for those of you who are choosing not to buy FS17 on launch. You'll be able to sort of continue on with the hard working as you however you like. And I know a few... Hang on, sorry, I was just trying to find the key. I was looking in three places at once. So yeah, I know a few of you have been asking for a save game. As I've done in this one, I didn't actually release the save game file for any of my Let's Plays this time round, but I probably will start releasing the save game file at the end of the Let's Play. I'll remove modded machinery, because if I've got a whole list of mods active on the map, it's a lot more difficult to make sure that I cover all of them so that you can successfully install a save game file. So it's just a lot cleaner and easier. There's much less likely to be errors for anyone involved if I only upload the save game with no mods in it. I think that'll just be easier all round. So I will upload files at the end of a series, but not during the middle. I'm not going to be uploading a save game file every week so that you can keep playing it partway through. We'll wait until the end and then I'll upload it. I don't want to be flooding the place with hundreds of save game files. I think it's just going to get confusing, so I'll just use one from each map that I've done. We are actually getting close to running out of time now. I'm wondering how I should go about doing it. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do long sweeping curves on this. We're going to get up there. I do like that he doesn't like going backwards up the hill, but this one will climb up the hill without any trouble in auto combine, which is pretty cool, especially considering the last one just didn't want to know. It was not going to happen at all, was it? So I'm going to go from the top here and start this one up. We've only got 25% in our trailer over there. We're still only 25% on the combine, to be honest, so we could be a little while. We'll finish up this field today, and I think we're going to try and have it so that we start our sugar beet harvest. We've got those three fields over there to harvest with sugar beet. My question for this week is, I've got the big square baler down there, the standard New Holland one. Do you want me to use that one to bale up the straw over in that field over there, which is field 10? Or do you want me to get the small welger baler, which is just through here, baling technology. And it actually uses that trailer there to auto collect them. And that is the baler. So that is a small baler. We'll use that to collect it up, and then we can put the bales down there somewhere and use the JCB to scoop them all up so that we can tip them into the cattle. I'm not quite sure how that's going to work. I'm not even sure if it will work properly. We'll learn that one together. I don't know how we're going to be able to feed, put bedding in for the cattle with the small bales. That one could prove interesting. Putting it in for the feeder, into the mixed feeder, that shouldn't be an issue. I don't think we'll have any problem with that. We'll wait and see on that one and see what pans out. Anyway, it's your vote. It's your game. Head to the comment section down below and let me know which baler you would like me to use. So I think, yes, definitely next week we will start harvesting that sugar beet over there. We are going to be using the Mahusiv Holmer Pterodos T440, which was against my recommendation, I might add. I have said this before, but I'm going to say it again. You realise we could spend most of our first episode with that massive great big machine stuck down there next to the barns because we just can't get it round the corner. I'm not going to go easy on you. I'm not going to get it out of those situations without you. If this is what you wanted, ladies and gentlemen, we're in this together. I will be... What is he doing? Why is he stopping like that? Hang on. Let's back him up. Start him up. Sometimes the hired help round here leaves a little to be desired. Oh, no, I don't want to do that. I want to turn that off and I want to spin round. We're only at 56%. I am going to unload this combine a minute. Let's come over to here. Now, is it going to go the right side? Yes, it is. So let's leap out of the combine a minute and run over to our tractor. We will take what little grain that we've got, we'll run it up, and we're going to sell this direct as well. Actually, if we've got some canola already, we will sell that as well. I'll gather that up from the grain bins, and we'll run that up, sell it all together, and see how much money we get. We'll check the price in a second. As soon as I've unloaded this bit, we'll go and check the price. Now, this is the tricky bit, is doing an inside curve without stopping the combine and reaching that spout. Because we got such a wide header, which isn't the recommendation for this combine, we struggle to reach our trailer. See? He's getting there, just... Oh, no, he's stopped. He's stopped completely now. He's given up. 30%. 25. 20. Right. And, hang on, while that's doing, let's just quickly check. How much have we got in here? We've got 8,369 litres, and it's selling for £1,000 a tonne. Well, £1,066 a tonne, which isn't bad. We've got 13 tonnes in our trailer. I think that combine is actually going to stop up the top there. So if I skip out a second, I'll run over here and see if he... Is he going to stop or is he going to turn around? Oh, he's going to do it. Okay. Well, now I'm dancing on top of the combine. That wasn't quite part of the master plan. I wouldn't recommend riding around on top of a combine when it's actually running. It gets a little bit dusty up there. I haven't done it, but I have had someone ride around on the combine that I was driving because they wanted to check something. And yeah, it was absolutely chokingly dusty. He lasted about 2 minutes before he got on the... He had a button on the radio. He couldn't really talk because it was so dusty. He just kept pressing the button, bleeping it at me to get me to stop. It was very frantically bleeping that button at me after just a couple of minutes. Now then, barley, wheat, OSR. That's the one that we want. I come under there. I'm guessing we've still got to press. Oh, yeah. So as long as you're under the right spout, it will automatically start filling. Well, I'm guessing that's just because we've got stuff in the trailer already. I think you've still got to select it. I can't remember now. I know we have taken some out of there. I can't remember if we had to press R and then select the crop or not. But we'll back up into here. I think when we start our sugar beet, that field would be the logical choice for starting. But I kind of want to start in that field just because it's really small and that's really going to test us, absolutely push us to the limits with what we can achieve with that massive great big sugar beet harvester. I might do it. I don't know yet. We'll see how difficult it is to get around this corner first. I think this is going to be a bit of a struggle to get through this yard. I really am wondering how we're actually going to do it. Right, as I've just about run out of time, I'm going to race up to the top and then I can say fairly well while we sell this canola. It does take quite a long time to get yourself up that steep hill when it's loaded up. I suppose a bigger tractor would help, but I did want to try and stick to medium and smaller tractors on this map. At least for now, until the final week when we go nuts. Right, let's bring that over there. So if you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me and get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. How much are we going to get? £23,144 for that load, which now leaves us with £308,000. There's still not enough to actually buy the Holmer, but we should easily be able to cover the higher cost. So we can certainly hire it for a day and just take it from there. I'll finish up this field of canola before next episode and sell it all in there. And then next week we can get started on our sugar beet harvest. I think this is going to be a lot of fun. I know I recommended the smaller machines, but I still think it's going to be highly entertaining using this massive, great big sugar beet harvester in these fields. So until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye and see you later.